Hello friends, welcome to Engineering Funda family. In this video, I'm going to explain you restoring division technique. Here, I'll be explaining you one very interesting example based on restoring division technique. And based on that, I'll be explaining you how we can have flowchart as well as circuit for restoring division technique. Like if you see over here, you can observe we are having flowchart over here, right? And this flowchart that you can easily understand once you see one example. So what I request you is, you just see one example and based on example only, you can easily make flowchart, right? At last, I'll explain you how this circuit that is there with restoring division technique. So let us start with one very interesting problem. I'll solve that problem step by step so that you can have fair enough idea about how we can have flowchart as well as circuit of restoring division, right? So if you observe here, we have been given with question in which 14 divided by 3 that we need to perform, right? So, if you observe 14, that is our dividend. Dividend is referred as Q and 3 is our divisor. Divisor is referred as M. So, first of all, we need to represent this dividend and divisor in binary. So, if you observe a dividend, then dividend that is given as per value 14 in decimal. In binary, it will be 1110, that is 14, right? Now, my dear students, first of all, you need to understand what is the significance of number of bits which is there with dividend. See, here dividend explains you that number of bits of dividend equals to number of steps to be performed while you do restoring division. So here, if you observe how many bits are there with dividend, here n is equals to 4 bits are there with dividend. What it means? We need to perform 4 steps to have restoring division. Now what I'll be doing is, I'll be mentioning all those datas over here. So first you'll have to initialize the values. So dividend that is 1110, right? Now my dear students, there are few basic things that you need to note down. See, value of accumulator that is 0. But to represent 0, how many bits that we need to have? So accumulator, that value is 0, but how many bits that we need to have? That will be number of bits of dividend plus 1. So if you observe, dividend is explained over here with 4 bits. So accumulator should be 0, but it should be 0 by 5 bits. So 5 times 0 that I need to mention over here, right? So here, my dear students, accumulator, that will be 0, but you should be representing with n plus 1 number of bits, right? Now, what is divisor? So divisor, that is 3 over here, right? And we need to represent divisor by number of bits which is there with accumulator. So when you write plus m, so that will be 3, right? But that we need to represent by 5 bits. So here, plus m, that will be 00011, that is 3 only, right? But we need to represent that by 5 bits. Now, my dear students, we will be using minus m as well. So, I need to convert this m into minus m. Right. Now, you should know, my dear students, in computer, minus m, that is 2's complement of m. Right. Minus m is 2's complement of m. So, here, 2's complement of this that we need to do. So, what you need to do is, you need to see from this side. And you will have to copy all the data till first one. So here first digit is first one only, right? So I need to write first one over here. After first one, whatever digits are there that I need to complement. So this one that will become 0 and this 000 that will become 1111. That is how minus m will be there, right? So this is how initial values that you need to have. First of all, you will have to see dividend. Then you will have to represent that in binary. Then you will have to represent accumulator. Accumulator will be 0, but how many bits that we need to have with accumulator? Number of bits of dividend plus 1. So here, dividend is having 4 bits. So accumulator will be having 5 bits. That will be representing 0 value of accumulator. Then divisor that we need to find as per number of bits which is there with accumulator. And plus m and minus m that we need to have. Minus m that you can have it based on 2's complement. Right. Now, here, you will have to perform steps. So, how many times we need to perform steps? So as per dividend is having 4 bits, you'll have to perform steps 4 times. So first, you'll have to do shift left operation in step, right? Let me mention that. So here, first of all, I need to make this bit as blank. And then this 0 is shifted over this side. This 1 is shifted over this side. This 1 is shifted over this side. This 1 is shifted over this side. And these all are zeros, right? So this is what shift left operation that we need to do. After that, you'll have to do subtract M operation with accumulator. So subtract M means what? You'll have to add minus M, right? So minus M is 111101. So I need to add 111101 with accumulator. So 1 plus 1, 0, carry 1, then this is 1, this is 1, this is 1, and this is 1. So that is how we have performed subtract M. Now, after subtract M, what you need to do? You'll have to see sign of accumulator. So sign of accumulator is 1. As if sign of accumulator is 1, then you'll have to perform restore operation. Let me mention that. Restore operation that I need to perform. In which condition? As if accumulator is having sign that is equals to 1. Right. Restore means what? See, here we were been performing subtract M. So in restore, we need to perform add M. Right. Now here, my dear students, one thing that you should know. We have done subtract M. If you do add M, then it will give you original value. I'm directly writing this value after having add M. So you see 4 times 0 and 1. That will be restore operation, right? So this is what we are restoring back. So we have done subtract M. Now, as if you perform restore, means you will be doing add M. In that case, you'll be getting original value again. And here you see 110 that we were been having, and I have mentioned this bit as blank. Now, what will be the value of this bit? That will be complement of this accumulator sign, right? So here that accumulator sign was 1. So now complement of that will be 0 over here, right? So that is how steps are there. Now I need to repeat these steps how many times? 4 times. So again, I'll be doing shift left operation. Now in that, first bit will be blank, then this is 0, this is 0, this is 1, this one will come here, this one will come here, and this 3 bits that will be 0. After that, I need to perform subtract M. So subtract M is what? 111101. You see, minus M, that is 111101. So that I need to add, means I'm doing subtract M, right? Now 1 plus 1, 0 carry 1, 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 1 plus 1, 0 carry 1. I need to ignore this, right? As we are not able to use this. Now here we need to see sign of accumulator. You see, sign of accumulator is 0. So as sign of accumulator is 0, you don't need to perform restore operation, right? See, as if sign of accumulator after subtract M is 1, then you will have to perform restore operation. As if sign of accumulator is 0 after subtract M, you don't need to perform restore operation. So what we need to do? Now we need to place this bit only. So see, 100 that we were been having, and this blank bit, that will be complement of this. So 0 is complemented over here, that will become 1. So restore that we need to do as if sign of accumulator is 1 after subtract M, right? Let us repeat these steps again. So third time, when you repeat this step, you'll have to perform shift left operation. So first bit that will be blank, this one that will come here, this 00 that will come here, this one that will come here, and all these 4 zeros that is getting shifted towards left side. After that, you will have to perform subtract M. In subtract M, you will be adding 111101. Now let us add this. So 1 plus 1, 0 carry 1, this is 1, this is again 1, 1, 1. So if you observe here, sign of accumulator after subtract M, that is 1. What it means? Here you'll have to perform restore operation. So when you perform restore operation, what you'll be doing? You'll be doing add M. So when you do add M, restore means what? It will be restoring this value. So that will be 00001, right? And this is 001, and this blank bit, now that will be complement of this. So that will be 0 over here, right? Now we have performed this step 3 times. Now 4 time again I'm repeating this. So let us do shift left operation. So here first bit will be blank, this 0 will come here, this 1 will come here, this 0 will come here, right? Now this 0 that will come here, this 1 will come here, and here you will be having 3 zeros. After that, you will be performing subtract m, means you will be adding minus m. So 111 01, and when you do add subtract m, you will be adding minus m. Remember this, means subtract m. So 0 plus 1 1 1 plus 0 1 then 1 1 1. Again, sign of accumulator is 1. What it means? You will have to perform restore operation, right? Means you will be doing add m operation. So restore means you will be restoring this value. So 0 0 0 1 0, and you'll have to complement this bit, and you'll have to make this bit to 0 over here, then 0 1 0, that I need to write. So here you see I'm having a is equals to, in decimal this is 2, and this q that is equals to 4 in decimal, right? Now you might be thinking, like, what is this? So this is our answer, my dear students, but let me show you how this is our answer. So you see what we were been doing, performing 14 divided by 3, right? So when you perform 14 divided by 3, then quotient will be 4 and remainder will be 2, right? So you see here this accumulator, that is 2, that is our remainder, and q is our quotient, right? So that is how answer is coming. Now my dear students, once you see how we can solve this question, you can easily see how we can have flowchart, right? So see, in flowchart, first of all, we'll be performing start operation. After that, n is equals to number of bits. Number of bits explains you number of steps to be performed. So we need to see dividend over here, and how many bits are there with dividend, that will define how many steps that we need to perform. M is our divisor. Accumulator should be 0, and accumulator should be represented by how many bits? Number of bits n plus 1, right? And then q is our divider. Now you will be performing steps. How many times? N number of times. What is that step? Shift left AQ, and then you'll be performing subtract M from accumulator, right? You see, we have been performing those steps every time. Shift left of AQ, and then subtract M. Shift left of AQ, subtract M. That is what we have been performing, right? After that, we have been checking sign of accumulator. As if accumulator sign is 0, then that unknown bit, that should be 1. As if sign of accumulator is 1, then that unknown bit, that will be 0. And in case of accumulator sign is 1, we need to perform restore accumulator operation, right? You see, what we were been doing, we were been checking sign of accumulator after subtract M. As if it is 1, then this unknown bit, that will be 0. As if it is 0, then this unknown bit, that will become 1, right? That is how we were been doing that operation. Now, my dear students, after that, we will be decrementing the value of n, and we will be checking value of n, whether it is 0 or not. If it is 0, then you will be having answer in accumulator and q. Accumulator explains you remainder, and q explains you quotient. But as if it is not 0, then you will be repeating this, right? So this steps that will be performing how many times? N number of times. So this is how flowchart is there. And if you observe the circuit, then you see in circuit, ALU is performing addition and subtraction, right, of this M with accumulator, and accumulator and Q, that is getting shifted by shift resistor, and that is what we are repeating n number of times. That is how we have circuit, flowchart and example. I hope it is clear to you still. If anything that you would like to share it with me, please note it down in comment box. I always read comments of my students. Thank you so much for watching this video.